glad I finally caught up with you. Congratulations! You have been randomly selected to win a fabulous prize from the Great Appalachian Sweepstakes.
The Great Appalachian Sweepstakes is not responsible for paying the required gift tax. Failure to do so may be reported to the IRS.
Enjoy your prize! Congratulations! Congratulations!
Overseer's log, Free State's bunker. Sam Blackwell and Raleigh Clay. Those damn traitors and their secessionists turned their backs on America to form their free states. Concrete bunkers. You'd never get that past a Vault-Tec radiation proofing inspection, that's for sure. Sounds like they let go of their paranoia long enough to seek out help from the other survivors. Just have to hack this terminal, see what they left behind in there, and what they wanted to do.
Stranger? Now, don't panic. My name is Abbie, I'm not your enemy, and this isn't a trap. In fact, if you're hearing this, it means I'm not even alive. I was with a group called the Free States. We gave our lives trying to finish what we called the Scorched Detection System. The system will let you know when the Scorched are coming and has the means to help deal with the Scorchbeasts. If you can help, I've created a set of recorded instructions to complete the system. First, you need to find the final communications uplink, and chances are high it'll need repairs. We entrusted it to a guy named Madigan and told him to place it on the antenna at top of the world. Find the uplink. You can use my workbench here to repair it. Then, check in at the main SDS terminal to trigger my next recording. If you're still there, I really hope you're willing to help a dead girl out. If so, good luck. And if not, well, enjoy dealing with the Scorched. And if by some chance this is Madigan, your timing sucks. your holotape. I'm pretty sure that everyone I know is dead. If we hadn't bothered with this stupid, stupid system, they'd all still be here. Well, guess what? If you all die, that kind of defeats the purpose. Why couldn't we just stay in our bunkers? Why do we even have to go out there? I'd rather eat cram every day and never see the sun again than be stuck here, alone. I miss my mom and my dad. You guys are supposed to be here. You took me away from my friends and my life all on your stupid promise that things were gonna be fine. That this was best. And is it? I can't do this on my own. I don't want to do this on my own. I just want things back the way they were. Message is playing, it means two things. The good, you've got a working uplink. The bad, some of the scorched detectors in the area are malfunctioning and need upgraded parts. It looks like my fear of the Myers ecosystem wreaking havoc on them has come true. For these repairs, first you need to get to Raleigh Clay's bunker. He's got replacement motors for the fans we use to keep the detectors dry. Oh, and write this down. R plus P421. It's Raleigh's password, and you'll need it. If you didn't catch that or you want more info, you can always check my workstation terminal. It's all there. Good luck.
that mean to love, to forgive?
This means you've made it to Raleigh's bunker. Which also means the Meyer detector fans must have cropped out. Next step is to find the replacement motors. If memory serves, they're in his generator room with the workbench. From there, you have the exciting task of finding some heating coils to upgrade them. This'll make the fans more effective to fight the moisture created by the swamp. Good news is, I have two in my bunker. Bad news is, you need three more. Raleigh's sure to have some too, so do a sweep while you're there. After that, your best bets are Ella Ames' bunker and the nearby relay tower. Once you've got enough, head back my way. I've got your next step set up to play once you're back. Hopefully. Oops, I forgot to add. Scenario 1. Addendum. Raleigh's got a few schematics stashed away that can help you make some protective gear for all this swamp trekking. It'll help you blend in, make it hard for nature's latest evolutionary wonders to spot you. So, could be useful. Abbie out!
Why we found you out there tampering with our stuff?
Hey, you guys are always holed up in your bunkers. How else can I get your attention? Besides, a crazy contraption like that? Of course I'm gonna try to figure it out. By the way, you guys came out fully armed and ready to fight. I'm guessing it's pretty big.
What you nearly broke was a Scorchbeast lure. It's the best defense we have against them.
Whoa, you're telling me you're luring those things down? You got some balls, Free States. Even with your numbers. Calling a beast is no easy task.
It doesn't just lure them down. We found some research and tech at one of the Brotherhood's old outposts. Hella realized if we can blast a scorched beast with a certain frequency, it disoriented long enough for us to go in and take it out. Neeraj and Abbie started work on the tech. We tested it. Works.
This is a real game changer, Raleigh. If what you say is true.
It's true, Hank. The system would be done if it weren't for those damn raiders.
Look, if this is as big as you think it is, the fire breathers can handle any raiders. But I need to know how the system works and see it in action first.
If you think we're gonna just reveal our work to an ex-Brotherhood member, think again. You wanna see how this system works, well, you've got some serious trust to earn. Shoved Emily out the door, and now you're doing it to me! I'm was your best friend for over 40 years. I trusted you to help me see this through. You acted like you gave half a damn about anything besides yourself. You could have helped me. Maybe I never would have made the decision to rebuild Harper's Ferry. Maybe half my family would still be alive.
Man. Whew. I feel like it's been non-stop missions for a while now. Gather supplies, head out, take a beat, set up a thing, take a few more beats, come home, heal up, rinse and repeat. Most days, I'm not even sure we're still alive. We've been working on this detection system for so long now, I feel like we'll never see the end of it. Detectors, lures, uplinks. I think I'd rather die than head back to another relay tower at this rate. But Raleigh and Nirid say it's worth it. And I believe them. Those Scorched are nasty business. And if I had the means to let people know they're coming, better yet, maybe take a Scorched piece out along the way? Hell yeah, I'd say it's worth it.
Thank you.
July 15th, 2079. Wow. Who would have thought a little radiation would turn this world upside down? We were down in those bunkers for what? A couple of years? There's no way radiation did all this all by itself in that amount of time. I mean, first off, this place is crawling with those orange-red vines, the likes of which there is no precedent for. I saw a toad that wouldn't even fit in a bathtub. A 12-point with two heads. Be still my heart. And insects. Oh, you don't even want to know about. I've started taking samples for analysis. Hopefully the plants can still be used for some good old holistic treatment. Raleigh's getting to work on a series of tests for the water. I don't know. I guess we can count ourselves lucky the air is breathable. But this place, I grew up here, and I barely recognize it. There's no way we were prepared for this. Toxicity levels, slight mutations, yes. But I'm telling you, Darwin would lose his mind out here.
Ella to give you this holotape on the event of my death. Please don't blame anything you're about to hear on her. These are my wishes. Ella has respected them, and I expect you to as well. I've been diagnosed with Parkinson's. I've still got plenty of time to live a normal life. Well, as normal as can be expected. But the time will come where my health will deteriorate and I can no longer care for myself. I love you both tremendously, and you know that, but I will not be a burden to you, my children, especially in these dark times. If everything has gone according to plan, hopefully my death has meant something. Please understand why I chose not to tell you. Abbie, you are smart enough to see our work through till the end. Calvin, you're turning into such a fine young man, your mother would have been proud, but not as proud as me. You two, take care of each other. You're going to make it through this. I know it.
Attention, citizens. Nuclear strike imminent. Please exit the area at your earliest convenience. Thank you for your cooperation.
automated warning to all responders. The Mr. Farmhands are out of control. Evacuate civilians. And take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, you'll have to reboot the server. Again.
Ugh.
doing this, it should mean you've got yourself 5 upgraded detector motors and 1 working uplink. Now for the fun part. First, you need to repair the damaged scorched detectors in the Mire. Second, that communications uplink needs to be set up on the antenna at Top of the World. You may or may not have encountered a lovely Miss Nanny there that goes by the name Rose. I programmed a holotape you want to give her along with the uplink. It explains how she can benefit from all this and get her to help us out. The only way we get that uplink set up is through that Miss Nanny. And finally, once you're done, you get to come all the way back here. Yep, that's right. We're not done yet.